Some things change, babe. Some things stay the same. Sometimes love wins, sometimes it's a losing game. Try to do it the easy way, but you see how big my heart was. Had my share of hurricanes, the proof is in the blood. But I can't.
I don't think that I've chosen an alternative route with my music this time around. I think I just kind of incorporated all the sounds that I've had throughout my career and applied them, and really, this is my first time being able to really go broader and bigger. So this is a song that I've been wanting to do for a long time. I think I just never had the right time to do it. So the reason why you now hear this is because I'm no longer caged to be able to just do one thing. I did not anticipate this acclaim, no, I did not, but I'm grateful for it. I was just doing and taking a risk. I knew I was taking a risk with this sound, but it was either do what everyone else wanted me to do or do what I was born to do. And this is what I've always wanted to do. This is the music I've always wanted to make. And I kind of felt like I paid my dues for this last 6 years being in groups and really doing my best to make sure everyone got their shine. And this time around, I really wanted to tell my story, and I'm just happy people love it. Yeah. It feels extraordinary to have people respect you and love you when you're independent and you don't have a label. Especially when I've had both dynamics, having a label as well as I know what it feels like to get recognition, having a label and a team behind you. But it's so much greater when seven people around you and you're working so hard for people to respect your craft when there's no one buying your spot or having the right person sell you your spot. You know, this is all based off of the people. And it's so much more rewarding when it's, you know, people are just doing it because they love it, not because they're told to love it. Oh, it's been perfect. It's helped me tremendously, the amount of love that I've gotten. And I think we've set a new lane for ourselves, especially being an R&B female independent artist. This is new boundaries and new territory. And I'm glad that they've showed us this much love, because it means that music is opening its eyes to new things and new and a new look for R&B. And not just R&B, for music, period. It affected it in such a beautiful way. Danity, Kane was one of the best things to ever happen to me. I think I couldn't have been the artist that I am now if I hadn't gone through that experience. And if I had to get in that line again, I'd do it in a heartbeat. I keep in touch with the girls from Danity, Kane, and Diddy. I haven't spoke to Kalina, but I know that there's like this, we don't ever have to, there's this unsaid respect, you know, I think because we've all been through so much that it doesn't really matter where we are in our lives. I think we'll always have those incredible moments that we shared, and I think you can't take that away from us, you know, and I think that's all that really ever matters. I felt honored, you know, it's one of those things where if you get to experience such such an amazing person and someone who's been in the business the way he has. And all of it wasn't perfect, but it was needed and necessary, especially for me as a businesswoman. And between my father and Puff, I think I'm so prepared for this music industry based off of the knowledge that both of them have given me. I've been inspired by many things. A lot of it was not even musical. My favorite painter, Gustav Klimt, an Austrian painter, was a lot of my influence. And him using gold flakes in his painting, it just seemed so regal. And there was something almost beautiful and royal about it. And I wanted my album to have this similar sound and look. And even the name, I wanted it to seem grand, you know? Those influences and a lot of painting and a lot of dance inspirations like Baryshnikov were the influences that kind of brought me to where my album is, and thus medieval at some times. And some people say even cinematic. I really wanted it to seem like a score. So those influences were heavy in my process for my album. No, it was always, I've always been this way. People don't even know, but my grandmother has a PhD in library science. So I grew up in the library. She's a librarian and she loved books. She loves research. And so I grew up around her a lot. And when I would have my half days at school, I'd spend time with her. And learning was something that she just loved to do. So it was something that I've always been. Chaucer, a fan of Chaucer and Hemingway. And I've always been that kid that loved and appreciated the arts. And I'm no different than that kid. And so for me, why not it be in my music? And even in the way I write my lyrical content, it's always a story. It's always whimsical. It's always magical. And that's always been me. I'm honored to be amongst those names, especially because they are signed artists now and they're Grammy winning artists as well. It's just me, you know, I'm just me doing what I love to do, and I think it's amazing. And I feel like to be the first female amongst those names is even more amazing, because I love to represent powerful, beautiful women. And I'm glad that people can see what we're doing is something of a trailblazing, and that I'm able to be amongst those names who are doing the same. I have an amazing foundation. My parents are my rock, and my mom would still whip me to this day if I said something crazy. I still have chores. I still have to go home and take care of the house. You know, I still have to respect them, and they make sure that I'm that Southern girl from New Orleans, Louisiana, that respects people and, you know, never take anything for granted. And I've lost a lot of things in my life to know how beautiful it is to have things. So, you know, that's just me. I'm just me. And I don't think that'll ever change. Be okay with taking risks, and be okay with knowing that none of it's gonna be perfect, that you will mess up a lot of times, and be okay with those mess ups, because those are the ones that prepare you for the great things to come. Just as long as your recovery and your bounce back is quickly, you'll be fine. I never felt restricted in the sense of with my freedom. I always found a way to express myself. There are moments of restriction, definitely. But where there was moments of restriction, I would find my freedom in other things. And the stage would usually be that freedom. so I would use it vocally. So when you'd see me on stage, I'd normally never sing the song the way it was originally sung. And people used to hate that, but that was my way of finding my freedom. But I mean, that's in anything. And even when you have your independence, like me being an independent artist, there still are restrictions because you are independent. So you always find that it's up to you to find your freedom in whatever situation you're in. I'm one of those people that never revert back. I haven't heard my listen to Danity Kane album in a very long time. I guess one day I will. I guess I'm never one to dwell. I'm always looking to the future. I'm always looking ahead. But sometimes I forget to look back. Yeah, Golden Heart is a brand. We'll definitely look into doing a lot more fragrances and acting and so much more that I haven't done yet. But music's the forefront, and I have to conquer that first. And I still feel like I have so much work to do. I didn't expect it at first, but since digitally, the amount of numbers we've done from you guys here, I expected it just because I love you guys so much here. And I think you guys get me. You get me. You get how innovative I want to be. And I feel like I don't have to have walls with you guys. Like, I feel like I can dream as big as I want, and you'll get it. Charting on Billboard, number 2 at Heat Seekers, and top 10 on R&B chart with no label and no feature. That's the highlight. There are no lows. Only things that could have been highs that just didn't meet it quite yet. If I got the right deal, I would definitely sign to a label. I have nothing against labels. I think they're fantastic and they're needed a lot of times when you're trying to bring your music to the masses. But I'm not forced or anything. If, you know, because what we're doing is fantastic too. So if the right deal comes along, I'll take it. If it doesn't, I'm quite fine with doing anything. Understood. Like, I hope my career is understood. I hope people know that I changed something here, that I took a risk here and it was for the better. I hope that my music is universal around the world. Awards. I'd love to see the Hearts get some awards. Not me, but my fan base. I'd love to see them win a couple of awards this year. Get some accolades, because they deserve it. What up, everybody? It's your girl, Dawn Richard, and I want you to keep it locked at www.thatflavor.com.